Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the class of 2015.
Thank you. Good morning. Welcome to Stony Brook. What a beautiful day for a graduation. I'm Dr. Edward Feldman. As president of the University Senate at Stony Brook, I will be the grand marshal for today's ceremonies. Here now, in the presence of the candidates for academic recognition, our Suffolk County representatives, members of the Stony Brook Council, our SUNY trustee, our faculty, administration, alumni, honored guests and friends of the State University of New York, the 55th commencement exercises are hereby convened. Please rise as you are able for the singing of our national anthem, led by recent PhD graduate Gloria Park, who has a beautiful voice, and please remain standing for the invocation delivered by Reverend Brenda Ford from our Interfaith Center.
Let us pray. Heavenly God, author of all life, the moment of graduation is here. Come and enter our graduation celebration and make thy presence known. You have given us a time and purpose in all things, a time to begin and a time to close, a time to put down roots and a time to move on. A time to learn and a time to apply learning with experience to bring meaning, dignity, and purpose to life. We give thanks to thee for the staff and faculty who have given us so many profound gifts, for they have been profoundly significant to us all. We rejoice today over the wonderful accomplishments of discipline, determination, and self-sacrifice that have led to this day of college graduation for the special graduates near and dear to us. It has been a great gift from you that they were able to learn from experts in their chosen field, and that they are now prepared to give of themselves in service in the realms of business, the academic world, the arts, medicine, education, government, social action, and research. May the skills that they have developed managing their time, setting priorities, and keeping focus during exams be the foundation on which they build successful careers and lives. We bless you for their dear families, where sacrifices, patience, and love have made this day even more joyful. We pray for continuous guidance, spiritual wisdom, and blessing upon each of these graduates. We commit our graduates into your hands. Give them the grace to make a difference for the good wherever they may find themselves in the years ahead. Thank you for your presence and bringing all of us to this wonderful day. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. We make this prayer with confidence in your holy name. Amen.
Please be seated. My pleasure to welcome the university's special guest today, the United States Congressman, the Honorable Lee Zeldin. New York State Senate Majority Leader from Northport, New York, the Honorable John Flanagan. New York State Senator, the Honorable Kenneth P. Lavalle. New York State Assembly Speaker, the Honorable Carl Hasty. And a Stony Brook graduate. New York State Assemblyman, the Honorable Steve Englebright. Suffolk County Legislator, the Honorable Kara Hahn. Brookhaven Town Councilwoman, the Honorable Valerie Cartwright. State University of New York Trustee, Carrie Stoller. Members of the Stony Brook Council, including Council Chair Kevin Law, Dr. Leonard Benedict, Christopher Hahn, Lewis Howard, Michael Smith, and Frank Trotta, the president of the Alumni Association, Carol Gomes, the president of the Graduate Student Organization, Jen Sidorova, the president of the Undergraduate Student Government in his last day in office, Gary Lacker. Senior class representative, Taisha Arnett Jordan. Thank you to each of our special guests for joining us on this special occasion. There's an African saying that states that it takes a village to raise a child. At Stony Brook, it takes a village to prepare a student for graduation. As president of the University Senate, I represent more than 2,200 faculty and 3,100 professional staff, many of whom have played a key role in helping you get here today. Will the representatives of the faculty and the professional staff anywhere in the stadium please rise? Please join me in thanking them for their contributions to your success. Thank you very much. I've worked with Stony Brook's president, Dr. Sam Stanley, for more than 6 years. You could not have a stronger champion for Stony Brook than Dr. Stanley. As a result of his leadership, Stony Brook's national and international reputation has grown significantly. The degrees that you will be awarded today are far more valuable as a result of this enhanced reputation. It is my distinct honor to present to you the president of Stony Brook University, Dr. Samuel L. Stanley, Jr.
Thank you so much, Professor Feldman, and I want to add my greetings to all present today, members of the faculty and staff, parents and friends of the graduates, our special guests, our distinguished honorary degree recipients, and above all, each and every individual in this beautiful sea of red on this field, our future, the class of 2015. So to all graduates, whether you did it in 3 years, or four, or more, that's okay. Today you cross the finish line, receiving a degree, and we're not going to be modest here, from one of the best universities in the world. Absolutely. Our faculty and staff work very hard to help every student succeed, but I don't think anyone can say that graduating from Stony Brook is easy. It's not. You've met that challenge, and you and your families should be so proud of what you've accomplished. You are among the 6,298 students that will graduate from Stony Brook University this semester. Our graduates today span 67 countries, 44 states, and range in age from 19. Is the 19-year-old here today? Yeah, they're raising their hand back there. Yeah, congratulations at age 19. Yeah, it's pretty impressive. To 81, 81-year-old here? Yeah. Maybe not, but that's still very impressive. And I'm proud of each and every one of you. And I want to tell you that your Stony Brook degree, and this is for parents in the audience as well, represents a very, very, very good investment. We were recently ranked the number one public school in the Northeast for return on investment. With increased earnings of approximately $1 million for in-state and out-of-state students. So that's a tidy chunk of change. And we will continue to push to do even better. I say this every year, but I mean it. We will work tirelessly to increase the value of your Stony Brook degree, improving the quality and reputation of this university, making your investment in Stony Brook, both of your time and money, the best investment you ever made. I know I speak for every faculty and staff member at Stony Brook when I say we are committed to excellence, committed to seeing this young university achieve greatness. You should expect nothing less. And of course, we have great expectations for you as well. After all, the success for our alumni is one of the seminal ways by which we are defined as a university. Your successes, your accomplishments, your good works are an integral part of how the world views us, of our effectiveness of a university. So class of 2015, we are pulling for you, and I know you won't let us down. Why am I so confident? Because some of your classmates have already done amazing things. Each year, I like to highlight just a few of the incredible graduates at Stony Brook University. I really would like to feature in each and every one of you, but I did the math, and even at 5 minutes per student, it would significantly prolong today's ceremony by about 8 days. So instead, I'm going to focus on just two. Marilyn Walker. Marilyn, would you please stand? She is. Marilyn came to Stony Brook from Brooklyn. I always hear applause from Brooklyn, yeah. And she grew up in the foster care system, and that alone is significant. You should know that fewer of 10% of children from foster care attend college, and only 3% graduate. What Marilyn has done is exceptional. Not only has she beaten the odds by graduating, but she has done it with academic distinction, graduating with honors. An EOP student. EOP student, there we go. Marilyn has given back to others by being involved with Stony Brook University's Children Defense Fund Freedom School since its founding in 2012. The school is following a single cohort of students from the Wyandanch and Longwood school districts and providing academic enrichment for them every summer at Stony Brook. Marilyn has taught every summer, and this summer will return as the site coordinator overseeing all teachers at the school. Having already received her BA, today, Marilyn graduates with an MS degree in social work, which she obtained in only 1 year. Marilyn, we congratulate you on your academic accomplishments, and your commitment to helping others follow your path to success. Great job. Dan Pilo, please stand. Dan. There he is. Dan Pilo graduates today with a BA in sociology. He has been on the dean's list every semester. Dan is also the vice president of the Stony Brook University Veteran Student Organization and a student mentor with the Vets for Vets program that helps new student veterans get acclimated to the university environment and succeed. Dan served as a U.S. Army Airborne Ranger, was deployed in Iraq and Kosovo, received the Purple Heart, Bronze Star, and Combat Infantryman Badge. Dan plans on attending law school after his graduation with a focus on helping neglected and abused children. Dan, congratulations on your graduation today, and thank you for your service to our country. These are just two examples of the lives of excellence that our students typically live, but I want to compliment all of you on your achievements. From Hurricane Sandy relief efforts, to creating a campus food pantry, to volunteering at our Long Island State Veterans Home, to working together through programs like the Red Watch Band and Green Dot to make our campus safer, our Stony Brook students are making a difference on our campus and in our region. So to all members of the class of 2015 who worked to make this university and this world a little better place, thank you. It's time to acknowledge one more group. I would like to extend a special word of thanks to the parents, relatives, and friends of our graduates who have helped them in ways material and otherwise to reach the academic goal they've attained today. Please join me in congratulating them. I know that it has not always been easy for you, that in some cases it required real sacrifice to make this day possible. But I also know the joy that a family member feels when a son or daughter, grandchild, niece, nephew, or close friend achieves an important goal, and I'm so happy to share that joy with you today. So to the graduates, let me say years from now, when you think about this day, and you will, what you remember most is not the commencement speeches or the details of the ceremony, but being with your loved ones, friends, and family members, and their joy at your success. And that's the way it should be. So beginning with move-in day and orientation, from your first class, maybe in Javits, your first college laboratory, to the Roth Pond Regatta, Earthstock, homecoming, celebrating our trip to the College World Series, sweating at the new rec center, attending an amazing concert with Ludacris, Childish Gambino, Loopy Fiasco, Panic at the Disco, or B.O.B., interacting with campus visitors like Bill Clinton, Tavis Smiley and Cornell West, Marion Wright Edelman, Carl Bernstein and Bob Woodward, and Neil deGrasse Tyson. I hope you had an extraordinary journey at Stony Brook University. Now go forth and prosper. Thank you very much.
Thank you, President Stanley. We now begin the conferral of degrees, starting with our honorary degrees. Today's honorary degree recipients have distinguished themselves by their contributions to their field, to society, and to the university. We are honored with the opportunity to recognize their achievements. Conferring honorary degrees on behalf of the State University of New York at Stony Brook is New York State Trustee Carrie Stoller, President Samuel L. Stanley, and Provost Dennis Asanas.
Will Charles Wong please come forward? You are a true leader whose generosity has touched countless lives, especially at Stony Brook University, where you helped to establish the Charles B. Wong Center for Asian and American Culture. The center serves as an inspiration to the community and is a focal point for many distinguished lectures and diverse student events. As co-founder of Computer Associates International and owner of the New York Islanders hockey team, you have earned both national and international acclaim. You are also known for your many philanthropic interests, including the Islanders Children Foundation, which you created, and the Smile Train, which you founded and actively support. For your unwavering commitment to enriching lives and for leaving an indelible impression on Stony Brook University and the greater Long Island community, the State University of New York is proud to bestow upon you the honorary degree of Doctor of Humane Letters.
By virtue of the authority vested in me by the State University Board of Trustees, the faculty of the State University of New York concurring, I confer upon you an honorary degree, honoris causa, and invest upon you with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto. In token thereof, I direct that you be provided with the diploma and vested with the hood representative of the specific degree conferred.
Wow. Have to tell you, this is really cool. And I'm truly humbled and honored by the kind of consideration of the Stony Brook University community in conferring to me the honorary degree of Doctor of Humane Letters at this 55th graduation ceremony. I'm proud to be a recipient of this degree, and I accept it with sincerest gratitude. I want to extend my thanks to President Stanley, Trustee Carrie Staller, Provost Dennis Asanis, and all the dignitaries represented here today. You know, as I look out upon here, this is unbelievable. I'm one that did not have the opportunity to attend my graduation from high school, nor from college. And here I am talking to you guys. It's pretty cool. You know, it's been a journey that you undertook many years ago when you started here at Stony Brook, and here you are today. You made it through college, and not just any college, but as President Stanley says, Stony Brook University. You are graduating from one of the top 60 research universities in the world. Well, I got ahead of myself. Maybe one day in the world, but this is top 60 in the United States. Your graduation is truly a remarkable achievement that you and your loved ones should be so proud of. It's a true testament to your hard work and sense of responsibility. And as this journey comes to the end and leads you to your new adventures, I want to share a little of my experience with you because now is your opportunity to choose what you want to be. Essentially, you are turning the page to a new chapter on life and find that it's blank, ready for you to write the rest of your story in. I know, don't worry, I'm not going to go through everything. I'm going to keep my message short because I know you all want to get back with your friends and family. You know, when President Stanley contacted me about receiving this honor, I thought to myself, why me? And finally, it took me a while, but I figured it all out. Stony Brook wanted me to be the opening act for Billy Joel. I came to the United States at the age of 8. I couldn't speak a word of English, and thankfully, I was the age of 8, and as you know, most kids adapt quickly. From there, the rest of my education was in the New York public school system, which I think is a wonderful system, gave us lots of opportunities. I attended Brooklyn Technical High School and went on to graduate from Queens College. As an alumni of Queens College, I had the opportunity to meet Dr. Shirley Kennedy when she became the president of Queens College. And when Shirley came to Stony Brook, I followed. You know, you can say that I'm a big fan and continue to be of Shirley. And I have to tell you, I really had no choice, since Shirley always reminded me that she knew all my grades and threatened to publish them. My admiration and friendship with Shirley is what led to the creation of the Wand Center at Stony Brook. We wanted it to be a place that would enrich the lives of all of the students here, a place where all can meet and share the diversity that makes this place so great. I want to continue. My journey really continues. I want to thank my family for their unconditional support and love. My family has always been the reinforcement of the values that I treasure most in life. So I'd like to leave you with some last thoughts that you may look to as you prepare to write the next chapter of your life. One, you can make a difference. What you do really does matter. Two, integrity, loyalty. Remember, they're only words until they are tested. Three, love life to the fullest. Live it. Live it as if it were your last day. And most importantly, and those who know me know I say this all the time, have fun. Congratulations to you, class of 2015. I wish you the best.
Will Mr. William Billy Joel please come forward? You are a beloved singer, songwriter, and pianist whose songs are treasured by generations of people across the globe, especially, okay, here we go, yeah. Thank you, sir. Especially here on your native Long Island. As one of the top-selling artists of all time, you have been honored by the Kennedy Center, inducted into the Songwriters Hall of Fame, and won 6 Grammy Awards. Your commitment to your home state is reflected in your countless contributions to New York City and Long Island, including very generous gifts of pianos to Stony Brook University, one following the loss of ours in a flood, making you truly our piano man. For all you have done for Long Island, and for all the joy you continue to spread through your music, the State University of New York is proud to bestow upon you the honorary degree of Doctor of Music.
By virtue of the authority vested in me by the State University Board of Trustees, the faculty of the State University of New York concurring, I confer upon you an honorary degree, honoris causa, and invest upon you with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto. In token thereof, I direct that you be provided with the diploma and vested with the hood representative of this specific degree conferred.
Hi. I was very happy to donate those pianos. I mean, if it's not the piano man, who else is going to do that? I also, like Mr. Wong, was unable to attend my graduation ceremony at my high school. I didn't attend the classes all that much the last year. But I was working. I was working at night. I couldn't get up in the morning. I got up in the morning. I was bleary-eyed. Everybody said, you know, oh, he's stoned out of his mind. And no, I was really tired. I'm one of the lucky ones. And before I forget, I do want to thank President Stanley and the faculty and the graduating class and our government officials and the parents and everybody attending here for honoring me with this. Like I was saying, I'm one of the lucky ones. I knew at a very young age what I was going to do. I know I was going to be a musician when I was really young, and I really never got distracted from doing that. And I'm going to keep this short because it's Memorial Day weekend, and I don't want anybody getting melanoma for, you know, sitting out here for too long. I hope that by now you have found what it is that you love. And I hope that you've learned the skills you'll need to make what you love your life's work. I wish for you the commitment to make what you love your life works. And I wish that for you the stamina to continue that work when you encounter resistance and tough times. And I believe this with all my heart. Because if you're not doing what you love, you're just wasting your time. Congratulations and good luck.
In honor of the first chairperson of the Stony Brook Council, the university presents its most distinguished undergraduate honor, the Ward Melville Maledictorian Award, to the graduating senior who has attained the highest academic average during 4 years at Stony Brook. Will chair of the Stony Brook Council, Kevin Law, and president of the Alumni Association, Carol Gomes, please come forward to join us in acknowledging the outstanding academic achievements of these graduates. This year, we have an unprecedented six-way tie, which I believe sets a new school record. Will the class of 2015's Ward Melville Valedictorians please come forward? David Chen, major biochemistry. Kelly Kelly Frevele, major political science. Elizabeth Ha, major biochemistry. Saif Lalji, major biochemistry. Janagan Nahanathan, major biology. And last one, Ariel Yang, major biomedical engineering. The H. Lee Denison Award, named in honor of Suffolk County's first chief executive, is presented by the university to the graduating senior or seniors who enter Stony Brook as a transfer student, completed at least 60 credits of letter grade work at Stony Brook, and attained the highest academic average in that work. This year, we have a five-way tie. Will the following awardees please come forward? Ian Backhus, major English. Cassandra Dix, major biochemistry. Jianji Meng, major computer science. Augusto Russo, major computer science. And Matthew Sacco, major English. I'm deeply honored to congratulate these outstanding graduates and wish them well as they take their Stony Brook experiences to the next level. Degrees with distinction are conferred upon candidates for the Bachelor of Arts, Bachelor of Science, or Bachelor of Engineering degrees who have completed at least 55 credits at Stony Brook, have letter grades assigned to at least 80% of their coursework, and attained the requisite GPA in their program. The levels of distinction are cum laude, graduating with honor and representing the 85th percentile, magna cum laude, graduating with great honor and representing the 93rd percentile, and summa cum laude, generating with the highest honor, representing the 98th percentile of all students. Attainment of a degree with distinction is indicated on each of these students' diplomas and on their permanent academic record. Last night, Stony Brook honored these graduates at the baccalaureate honors convocation, during which the stoles that each are wearing were presented. Will candidates graduating with the distinctions of cum laude, magna cum laude, and summa cum laude please come and be recognized? It's now my pleasure to introduce the Vice President for Student Affairs, Dr. Peter Begent.
Each year, the class speakers, the selected from a pool of submitted speeches provided through the annual senior speaker competition. All the entries are reviewed and judged by a committee of staff and faculty. They made an excellent choice when they selected Ashley Risotto. Ashley is graduating today with a bachelor's in sociology. In addition, she minors in women's and gender studies and in health and wellness. She graduates today, cum laude, and will be pursuing a master's degree in higher education and student affairs this fall at the University of North Carolina, Greensboro. Please welcome your student speaker, Ashley Risotto.
Welcome, students, staff, faculty, family, friends, and Billy Joel, as well as Charles Wong, to a bittersweet day. A day of celebration for all the good to come, and sorrow for all that we leave behind us. Today, we can reflect and embrace everything that has brought us to these seats. I want you all to think back to the moment when you became a seawolf. Was it the success of completing your first semester? Was it your first homecoming game? I remember coming onto this campus 4 years ago for opening weekend. I could feel the excitement of starting my journey here hit me all at once. As my mom was driving up to the residence hall, I couldn't help but exclaim, "I'm home!" ready to jump out of the seat the second my mom stopped the car. And I had a rocky start here, but I knew right away that I was a seawolf and I had found the right place for me. And I know that wasn't everyone's experience, but I do know that your personal journey of academic and social success started somewhere here and will stay with you forever. Even though we all come from different backgrounds and are leaving with different lessons learned, whether we started as a freshman or a transfer, no matter how long it took us to get to this spot today, we are always united as sea wolves. Please don't forget, life is about the journey. It's about the decisions you make and stand for. It's about how you deal with adversity and who you look to for support. It's about the passions you've discovered and keep with you forever. And it's how there will always be a piece of Stony Brook University in your heart. Don't forget to thank those that have supported you and helped you along the way, those that challenged you to become a better person over these past several years. Most of all, thank yourself because of your dedication, your persistence, your hard work to creating a stronger you. We stepped into this stadium as undergraduate students and are leaving as proud alum of the class of 2015. In conclusion, I'd like to quote one of my favorite public speakers, Brené Brown. Wholehearted living is about engaging our lives from a place of worthiness. It's about cultivating the courage, compassion, and connection to wake up in the morning and think, no matter what gets done, or remains undone, I am enough. I hope that we can all know we have done everything in our power to achieve success and continue to live wholeheartedly and proudly as seawolves. Now, seawolves, I have one more question for you. What's a seawolf? What's a seawolf? Seawolves, what is your profession? Thank you.
Thank you, Ashley. Will President Stanley please join class, senior class representative Taisha Arnett Jordan at the lectern for a special presentation from your class of 2015.
Good afternoon, President Stanley, esteemed platform members, faculty, parents, family, friends, and fellow students. Congratulations, class of 2015. We finally made it. My name is Taisha Arnett, and I'm a senior class representative, and I'm excited to talk briefly with you about the student giving campaign. In 2004-2005, the class representatives and the Office of the Dean of Students established a student giving campaign which allows students to give back and show their support for Stony Brook. Over the years, the money raised through the student giving campaign has helped to advance scholarship, advance the reach of the university's research and service, enhance student life, and to help restore the communities. As an important part of the student giving campaign is the senior class gift. For the last 10 years, the graduating seniors have come together to present a gift at commencement as a way of leaving our legacy on campus and thanking Stony Brook for all it has given to us. The graduating class of 2015 is pleased to continue this important tradition. As contributors to the campaign, we are not only helping leave our mark here at Stony Brook, but are demonstrating our citizenship to the world and the first step in becoming loyal, active alumni. I am proud of the generous spirit our graduating class has, and I'm excited to report that the senior class has raised $8,613 for various funds to support the university's scholarly, educational, and humanitarian efforts. The amount raised for the student giving campaign has totaled to $250,000 for over the last 10 years. Dr. Stanley, as a senior class representative, I am thrilled to present you with a check for the Stony Brook Foundation. We hope that our contribution would allow us to leave a living legacy to the university and to the community. Now, Seawolves, we're gonna try this again. When we ask you this question, I want you to get up and act like it's your first Thursday as a freshman, or like right now, as your last Friday as a senior. So, Seawolves, what is a seawolf? I can't hear you. What is a seawolf? Seawolf, what is your profession? All right.
Every year, master's and bachelor's candidates are individually acknowledged during their department, college, school, or program convocations. Today's graduation candidates will be acknowledged as a group and presented to President Stanley by their deans. I invite the Dean of the School of Nursing, Dr. Lix Hippolytos, to begin the presentation of our candidates.
Will the candidates for the Bachelor of Science and Master of Science degrees in the School of Nursing please stand? President Stanley, I have the distinct honor to present to you this year's School of Nursing candidates. Candidates, please sit. It is my pleasure to now introduce the Dean of the School of Social Welfare, Dr. Francis Brisbane.
will the candidates for the Bachelor of Science and Master of Social Welfare degrees in the School of Social Welfare please stand? President Stanley, with great pleasure, I present to you this year's School of Social Welfare candidates. Please welcome Dr. Craig Lehman, Dean of the School of Health Technology and Management.
Will the candidates for the Bachelor of Science and Master of Science degrees in the School of Health Technology please stand? President Stanley, I present to you this year's candidates for the School of Health Technology and Management. Please be seated. It is now my pleasure to introduce Dr. Charles Tabor, Vice Provost for Graduate and Professional Education and Dean of the Graduate School.
Will the candidates for the Master of Arts in Liberal Studies, the Master of Professional Studies, the Master of Arts in Teaching, the Master of Science in Human Resources Management, the Master of Arts in Higher Education Administration, Postmaster Certificates in Educational Leadership and School District Business Leadership, and Advanced Graduate Certificates from the School of Professional Development please stand? President Stanley, I present to you this year's School of Professional Development candidates. Candidates, please be seated. I now invite Dr. Minghua Zhang, Dean of the School of Marine and Atmospheric Sciences, to come forward.
Will all candidates for the degrees of Bachelor of Science, Master of Science, and Master of Arts from the School of Marine and Atmospheric Sciences please stand? President Stanley, I am proud to present to you the School of Marine and Atmospheric Sciences candidates. Candidates, please be seated. It is now my pleasure to introduce Dean Howard Schneider from the School of Journalism.
Will the candidates for the Bachelor of Arts degree from the School of Journalism please stand? President Stanley, I present enthusiastically and proudly this year's School of Journalism candidates. Thank you. Will Dr. Heidi Huttner, Director of the Sustainability Studies Program, please come forward?
Will the candidates for the Bachelor of Arts degree from Sustainability Studies please rise? President Stanley, I present to you this year's Sustainability Studies program candidates. Candidates, please be seated. It is now my pleasure to introduce Dr. Manuel London, Dean of the College of Business.
Thank you, Heidi. Will this year's candidates for the Bachelor of Science and Master of Business Administration degrees in the College of Business please stand? President Stanley, I present to you the College of Business candidates. Candidates, you may now be seated. Please welcome Dr. Yaakov Shamash, Dean of the College of Engineering and Applied Sciences, to present his candidates.
Will the candidates for the degrees of Bachelor of Engineering, Bachelor of Science, Master of Science, and Advanced Graduate Certificates in the College of Engineering and Applied Sciences please stand? President Stanley, it's with great pleasure I present to you the College of Engineering and Applied Sciences candidates. Thank you. You may be seated. It is now my pleasure to introduce Dr. Sasha Kopp, Dean of the College of Arts and Sciences.
Candidates from the College of Arts and Sciences for the Bachelor of Science degree, the Bachelor of Arts, the Master of Music, the Master of Science, Master of Arts, Master of Fine Arts, Advanced Certificates, please rise and be recognized. President Stanley, these are your candidates from the College of Arts and Sciences. Please be seated.
At this time, I invite all candidates for the degrees of bachelor's, master's, and advanced certificates from all colleges and schools and programs to rise. President Stanley, I have the honor to present to you these candidates of the best graduating class ever, and respectfully request that you confer upon them the degrees and certificates for which they are qualified.
By the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees, and upon recommendation of the faculty, I confer upon all of you who have completed the respective requirements, the degree of Master of Arts, Master of Fine Arts, Master of Science, Master of Music, Master of Social Welfare, Master of Arts and Liberal Studies, Master of Arts and Higher Education Administration, Master of Science and Human Resources Administration, Master of Professional Studies, Master of Arts in Teaching, Masters of Business Administration, Masters of Public Health, Advanced Certificates, the degree of Bachelor of Arts, Bachelor of Science, and the degree of Bachelor of Engineering, with all of the rights, privileges, and responsibilities pertaining thereto. Congratulations. Graduates, you may now turn your tassels from right to left. You can throw your caps in the air. Celebrate. Before we close, I'd like once again to extend a special word of thanks to the parents, relatives, and friends of our graduates who helped them realize the academic goal they attained today. I invite you all to stand and be recognized by our graduates for everything you did. Anyone who can, please stand and be recognized. Thank you so much.
I invite everyone to please rise and join our graduate, Gloria Park, in singing Stony Brook's Alma Mater, which can be found in your program on page 81.
Ancient ground, where newborn dreams.
So as we conclude our ceremony, I call your attention to the big screen for a very brief summary of what's happened to you over the past 4 or 5 years. Take a look.
Congratulations, Class of 2015, and good luck with all your future endeavors.
It's been a great 4 years. Go Sea Wolves.
Congratulations! We made it! Goodbye, Stony Brook!
We'll miss you, Stony Brook.
Way to go, seniors.
I'll always remember you, Stony Brook.
Congratulations to Stony Brook University students for graduating. I hope to see you guys in the future.
Thank you, Stony Brook, and congrats, Class of 2015.
Congratulations, Class of 2015, all my classmates, and as well as the student-athletes like me. Congratulations, Sea Wolves for life.
We made it, homies! Let's go!
Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes the ceremony. Congratulations to all of our graduates. Congratulations.